Students, here are some COVID-19 appropriate behavior. So here there are some instructions regarding your COVID-19. So the instructions are: wear masks, follow physical distancing, maintain hand hygiene. So these all instructions you have to follow. First is wear mask properly. So you all have to wear your mask properly. Second, stay at least 6 feet from others. Third, wash your hands frequently, always with soap and water for at least 20 seconds. Remember to not touch your face. Do not share food or drinks with others. So these are your instructions regarding COVID-19. So students, in this video we are going to continue the chapter 7, congruence of triangles. So here we are going to start with a question. In the following figures, lengths of the sides of the triangle are indicated. So here in this question, we have been seeing that the figures have been given to us and that the sides of our triangle are indicated. That means here a pair of triangle is given to us and the sides have been mentioned. By applying the SSS congruence rule, state which pair of triangles are congruent. So here we are going to use the SSS congruence rule and tell which pair of congruent triangles are congruent. Which pair of triangles are congruent? This is a pair of triangle, and in this pair we can see that there is two triangles. Triangle ABC and triangle PQR. These are your two triangles, and here in these two triangles we can see that AC is equal to PR, that is 5 cm. This is side, and next BC is equal to PQ, again 4 cm. That means again both two sides are equal. This is a corresponding part, AC and PR. This is also corresponding part, BC and PQ. Again, they are corresponding parts and they are equal to each other. And the third side, that is AB, is not equal to QR, because AB is 2 cm and QR is 2.5. So that means here, this is not equal, this is not equal side. So we can say that therefore, triangle ABC is not congruent. This is a symbol of not congruent to triangle PQR, because the third side is not equal. Third pair of side is not equal. That means we can't apply the SSS congruence rule in this. So that means they are not congruent. Now the second part. In the second part, we have been given a triangle, and in this triangle we can divide this triangle into two triangles, ADB and ADC. We can take two triangles, ADC and triangle ADB. ADC and ADB, we have taken two triangles. Now here we can say that AC is equal to AB. That means that is how much? 3.5 cm. That is side. S stands for side. And next, here we can see that BC is equal to DB. That is of 2.5 cm. Again side. And we can see that in both the triangles, AD is common. AD is common. That is again a
side.
Second, the here we can see that SSS rule is coming. That means triple S congruence rule is coming. So we can say that triangle ADC is congruent to triangle ADP. So here, with the help of sides, we can specify and prove that triangle ADC is congruent to triangle ADP. In this way, we can prove. Now, students, the next question is which congruence criterion? Here, the criterion means the congruence rule. Do you use in the following? So here we have to specify that which rule we can apply in this figures. So first, we have been given pair of triangles LMN and FGH. We have been given two pair of triangles here. In this, we have been given angle MLN is equal to angle FGH, and this is your corresponding angle. That means angle MLN, this is being given, that means this is your angle and this angle is equal to FGH, this angle, that is your one corresponding part. The next corresponding part is angle NML is equal to angle GGFH, and this is also again the next corresponding angle NML. This is our angle, second angle, and this is equal to GGFH. This is your second pair of corresponding angles. And next, we have been given ML is equal to FG. That means ML. ML is coming here. This is equal to FG. That means this is your side. So we can say that. So triangle LMN is congruent to triangle GFH because of ASA tool. So angle side angle, and this ASA rule, we can prove that triangle LMN is congruent to triangle GFH. Now the second part, again the figure is being given, and here in this figure we have been given two triangles, triangle ABE and triangle CDB. We have been given two triangles, and now we have to prove that both are congruent. Why they are both are congruent? So listen here. We have been given EB is equal to DB. That is your side. EB is equal to DB. That is one pair of corresponding side. Next, we have been given angle A equal to angle C, that is of 90 degree, that is right angle. And we have been given one more side, that is AE is equal to BC, that is your side. So we can say that triangle ABE is congruent to triangle CDB by the rule of RHS. That means right angle hypotenuse side. That is right angle hypotenuse side. So in this way we can specify that this triangle is congruent to triangle CDB. So students, now the next question is, we want to show that triangle ART is congruent to triangle PEN. So here we have been given two pairs of triangle ART and triangle PEN. And if it is given that AT is equal to PN and you are to use AFA criterion, you need to have. So now here we are saying that if the side AT is equal to PN, the side AT, this is your side AT and this side is AT is equal to PN. Now we have to use the ASA, and in ASA we need two angles and one side, and one the side has been given to us. That means we have to name the two angles, two pair of corresponding angles. That means first angle ART, this angle ART, this is your corresponding angle, and this corresponding angle will be equal to the angle NPE. This angle will be equal to NPE. That means we can say that this is equal to NPE. So in this way we can find out our missing corresponding angle. And next, the second angle will be, if angle ATR here, that means ATR, this is your one pair of corresponding angle, and this will be equal to ATR. That means here we have been given ATR, that means this angle will be equal to PNE here. So we can name it as angle PNE. So in this way we can find out our missing corresponding angle that is equal to the given angles. Now the next question is, in the figure the two triangles are congruent. So here we have been given a pair of triangles and both are congruent to each other. The corresponding parts are marked here. In this triangle we can say that the corresponding parts are marked. We can say that right triangle RAT is congruent to triangle missing triangle. We have to name the missing triangle. So here the parts that are corresponding to each other, that means first part will be angle RAT, and this angle RAT is equal to angle WON. That means this is a one pair of corresponding angle. The next will be angle ATR. So this is equal to angle ONW. This is again a second corresponding angle, and third will be your side. Any side you can take. I am going to take AT. AT is equal to NO. That is your side. So we can say that triangle RAT is congruent to triangle WON by the rule of ASA, angle side angle. Two angles are there and one side is there. And because of this congruence rule, we can say that triangle RAT is congruent to triangle WON. Now, students, the next question is complete the congruence statement. And the congruence statement is triangle QRS is congruent to dash. So here we have to complete this statement. Triangle QRS is congruent to triangle. We have to name the triangles. So here we are going to take two triangles, triangle QRS and triangle TPQ. We have taken two triangles. So now we have to name the corresponding parts. So first corresponding part will be PT is equal to QR, that is side PT. PT is equal to QR. This is what here the markings have been done in the question. This is your first single marking. PT is equal to QR. That means your first side. Second side will be PQ. PQ will be equal to SR. That is also a side. That means three markings is equal to three markings. That means PQ equal to SR. And third side is TQ is equal to QS. That is your third side. That means here these two triangles, triangle QRS is congruent to triangle TPQ by the rule of SSS. That means side, side, side. In this way, we can complete the congruence statement. Now, next question is explain triangle ABC congruent triangle FED. Here, we have been given pair of triangles. That means first pair is triangle ABC and second pair is FED. So we have to prove their congruence. So first, here angle ABC is congruent to FED. That means this is your right angle because both is making an angle of 90 degree. This is your 90 degree and this is also a 90 degree. That means angle ABC is equal to FED. Next is BC. Here in this we can say that your hypotenuse side here will be AC. AC will be your hypotenuse side and that will be equal to FD. That is your hypotenuse side because that side is opposite to 90 degree. This side AC is opposite to 90 degree and this side is also opposite to 90. That means AC equal to FD. Therefore, we can say that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle FED because of right hypotenuse side, right angle hypotenuse side. In this way, we can prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle FED. Friends, now we are going to discuss an activity on congruent triangles. That means in this activity we can say that how we can prove that any pair of triangles are congruent. So first is observe the triangle in the box. So here we have been given a triangle in the box. Identify the triangle congruent to it from the triangles given. So here the one triangle has been given inside a box and we have to identify that which triangle is congruent to a triangle given in the box. This is your one type of activity. And now here the triangle that has been given in the box, we can say that there are the corresponding parts is AB, AC and angle A. Now,
these corresponding parts will be equal to, that means here we can say that both the sides are making an angle of ADA and both are making angles at A. So that means the corresponding part of AB will be EF and AC will be ED. That means both EF and ED both are making angles at E. That means here the corresponding parts of this triangle will be, we will found in this triangle. That means this triangle is congruent to this triangle. That means here we are applying the which rule to two sides and one angle. That means the angle will come as side angle side. That means this is your criterion, and in this we can say that this triangle is congruent to this triangle by the rule of SAS criterion. In this way we can find out that which triangle is congruent to which triangle. Now students, here this is the second part of your activity. Observe the triangle in the box. Identify the triangle congruent to it from the triangles given. And after identifying, then you have to click on the appropriate congruency rule. By you can click means we have to find out which congruence rule we are going to apply here. So the figure that has been given inside a box, here we can see that in this figure, that is a triangle, there is a right angle at Q, and that means the side opposite to angle Q is PR, that is your hypotenuse side. So here we have to identify that which of these two triangles is congruent to a given triangle in the box. Here the angle is at making a Q, that means here the angle is making a D, that means this angle D is congruent to angle Q, that means this is your corresponding angle Y, and the side that is opposite to angle D is EF, that means EF is congruent to PR, that means that there are corresponding parts. And the remaining, the second triangle is, here we can say that there are two sides equal. That means this condition we can't apply in this triangle. That means out of these two, this triangle is congruent to a triangle given in the box. And here there is a right angle. That means out of these four rules, we can apply the RHS, right angle hypotenuse side. That means this right angle and hypotenuse side, that means RHS is your rule. Here we are going to apply to prove the congruency rule. The question that I have done in the here in this video, I'm going to give you the same type of sums in your worksheet. Hope you all have understood. Thank you.